All the class 9 students of St. Michael's Academy, welcome to another online physical science class. Today I am going to start solution. It's a very important chapter, so let's start. What is solution? A solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. A solution may exist in any phase. So, solution consists of a solute and a solvent. The solute is the substance that is dissolved in the solvent. For example, in a saline solution, salt is the solute dissolved in water as the solvent. So, of these two components of solution, solvent and solute, which one be termed as solvent and which one will be termed as solute? If the components of the solution exist in different physical states, then the solvent is that component which exists in the same state as the final solution. In case the components are in the same state, the component present in larger amount is called the solvent, and the component that is dissolved in the solvent, usually present in lesser quantity, is called the solute. Now, properties of solutions. A solution is composed of the solute, the minor component, a least number of moles, and the solvent, the major component, largest number of moles. Soluble or insoluble. A soluble substance readily dissolves in the solvent. An insoluble substance will not dissolve readily in a solvent. Miscible or immiscible. Two liquids are miscible in each other if they readily mix to form a uniform solution. Two immiscible liquids will always separate out into two distinct layers. Solubility describes the amount of solute that will dissolve in a solvent. For example, 35.7 gram of sodium chloride or table salt or common salt will dissolve in 100 milliliter of water at 0 degree Celsius, no more. So, a solution is made by dissolving a solute in a solvent. One GIF has been shown over here. When the solute is added to the solvent, it's becoming a solution. Now, examples of some solution. There are many such examples. This one example I am giving. Suppose air. Air is a homogeneous mixture. It is a solution. But gas in gas, like this. Now, there are some characteristics of a perfect solution. The solution can exist in liquid, gaseous or solid. In fact, a combination of liquids, gaseous and solids can be a solution. In some cases, the solution like seawater consists of a large number of different types of solutes such as salts, oxygen and organic molecules. So, characteristics of solution, you can say that a solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. Homogeneous means same molecule size. So, the particles of solute in a solution cannot be seen by the naked eye. A solution doesn't allow beams of light to scatter. A solution is stable. The solute from a solution cannot be separated by filtration or mechanically. So, a solution can exist in any state. See the diagram, please. First one is solid. Like this, brush is a solid solution because brush is an alloy. That means a homogeneous mixture of copper and zinc. Now, liquid solution. Sugar water is a liquid solution. Because sugar water is a homogeneous mixture of sugar and water. Now, in case of gas, air is a gaseous solution. Because air is a homogeneous solution of nitrogen, oxygen and carbon dioxide. Examples of solutions. Some examples of solutions are salt water, rubbing alcohol, and sugar dissolved in water. When you look closely upon mixing salt with water, you can't see the salt particles anymore, making this a homogeneous mixture. This is the part where the solute is dissolved. In our example of salt water, the solvent is water. See the diagram. Salt water. When you are mixing salt in water, it's becoming a homogeneous mixture or solution. So that's why it is called a solution. Now, examples of household solutions would include the following. You know this. You just listen to me properly. First one is coffee or tea. Sweet tea or coffee. That is sugar added to solution. Any type of juice, salt water, bleach, that is sodium hypochlorite dissolved in water. Dish water, that is soap dissolved in water. Carbonated beverages. Carbon dioxide dissolved in water in what gives sodas their fizz? Powdered drinks. Please remember the names of the household solutions. Now the other examples. Sugar is dissolved in water and the final solution is liquid solution. So water is the solvent and sugar is the solute here. 10% alcohol in water, both the components and the final solution is liquid. Water in excess, so water is the solvent. Aerated drinks like soda water here, carbon dioxide, solute dissolved in water. So, water is the solvent because here gas is liquid, dissolved in a liquid. A solid in another solid, for example, alloys, a metal or non-metal dissolved in a metal, it is solid solution. The gold used in making jewelry is a solid solution containing gold and small quantities of copper or silver. Air is a homogeneous mixture containing gold, containing the gases, containing nearly 21% oxygen and 78% nitrogen and small quantities of other gases like water, carbon dioxide and inert gases. That means these are the examples of solution. Now here, I'm starting the divisions of solutions. Firstly, solutions has been divided into two main parts. One is homogeneous solutions and another one is heterogeneous solutions. Homogeneous solution is a true solution and heterogeneous solutions have some subdivision, two subdivisions. One is suspensions and another one is colloids. So, true solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances in which substance dissolved, that is solute, in solvent has the particle size of less than 10 to the power minus 9 meter or 1 nanometer. Simple solution of sugar in water is an example of true solution. Now the question is salt is a true solution? Salt water is a true solution because it dissolves completely in water and it makes a homogeneous mixture. Now the next question is milk is a true solution? Milk is not a solution because it has more than one phase suspended in it. It has a liquid phase and a solid phase. Unhomogenized milk is not a solution. It's a suspension because the fat, that is cream, will separate from the rest of the milk and rise to the top. Since fat is less dense than water. So, you can say that the solution in which the size of the solute particle is nearly 10 to the power minus centimeter to 10 to the power minus 10 meter or less is called a true solution. The term solution actually means true solution. Now, properties of a true solution. A homogeneous mixture of two or more components whose ratio can be varied. The dissolved solute is molecule or ionic in size that is less than 1 nanometer. It can be colored or colorless. True. Those solutions are usually transparent. The solute remains dissolved and doesn't settle out of solution over time. That means No precipitation occurs in case of solution. Now number 5, the solute can be separated from solvent by physical means, usually by evaporation. Separation of liquids, in separation of liquid chapter you have read this evaporation process. So true solution is a homogeneous mixture. Solute particles are small, less than 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter, that is 10 to the power minus 10 meter. Due to small size of the solute particles, they do not scatter a beam of light passing through the solution. The solution is clear and transparent. Components can't be separated by filtration. Solute particles do not settle down when left undisturbed. That means no precipitation occurs. Previously only I have discussed. That is, it is a stable solution. Now, I am discussing about colloids and suspension. Before starting this, see the diagram. Solution means a solution is a homogeneous mixture when two or more substances are dissolved together. Second, colloids. A colloid contains particles that are in between in size. They do not separate into layers. Fog is a colloid. A property of a colloid is a scattering of light. Now suspensions. A suspension is a heterogeneous mixture. It separates over time. A great example is oil and vinegar or sand and water. Now starting, what is suspension? A suspension is a heterogeneous mixture in which the solute particles do not dissolve but get suspended throughout the bulk of the solvent, left floating around freely in the medium. So a coarse suspension is a heterogeneous mixture in which the solute particles do not dissolve but remain suspended throughout the medium. The suspended particles of a suspension is visible to the naked eye. Example of suspension, you can give chalk powder suspended in water, muddy water, smoke from chimney, etc. Now next one is colloids. Colloids, also known as colloidal solutions or colloidal systems, are mixtures in which microsporically dispersed insoluble particles of one substance are suspended in another substance. The size of the suspended particles in a colloid can range from 1 to 1000 nanometers, that is 10 to the power minus 9 meters. So in colloids, the size of solute is between 10 to the power minus 7 to 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter, that is 10 to the power minus 9 to 10 to the power minus 7 meter. The solute particles neither settle down nor homogeneous mixture with the solvent. This is called colloid. Colloid is a heterogeneous mixture. It has two phases. The substance which remains in colloidal particle size is called the dispersed phase, and the medium in which this particle remains suspended is called the dispersion medium. Please remember these two phases of colloids. One is dispersed phase and another one is dispersion medium. Examples of colloids: milk, starch solution, milk of magnesia, jelly, mist, etc. Now, the properties of suspension and colloids. General characteristics and properties of suspension are a heterogeneous mixture of two or more substances. Particles of the solute do not dissolve in the solvent, rather they remain suspended in bulk throughout. The size of particles of suspension is large enough to be visible from naked eyes. Now the properties of suspension. Nature, heterogeneous in nature. Visibility, it can be seen with naked eyes. State of the particle, or size of the particle rather, size of the suspended particles in nearly 10 to the power minus 4 centimeter, that is 10 to the power minus 6 meter. Sedimentation, particles of suspension have a tendency to settle down when left undisturbed. That means there is a tendency of precipitation. Separation, particles can be separated by filtration. Now the next properties of or characteristics of colloids. First, stability. Colloids are relatively stable in nature. The particles of the dispersed phase are in a state of continuous motion and remain suspended in the solution. Now, filterability. Colloids require specialized filters known as ultrafiltrates for filtration. They readily pass through ordinary filter papers without yielding any residue. Heterogeneous nature. Since colloids consist of two phases, the dispersed phase as well as the dispersion medium, they are known as heterogeneous in nature. Homogeneous appearance. Even though colloids have suspended particles and are heterogeneous in nature, they appear as if it is a homogeneous solution. This is because the suspended particles are so tiny that they are not visible by the naked eye. So, visibility is also there. Particle size being very small cannot be seen by naked eyes. And one more points are also there. Here, stability is there, filterability is there, heterogeneous nature is there, homogeneous appearance is there. Visibility is there and colloidal particles shown Brownian movement. What is Brownian movement? The colloidal particles in dispersion media move continuously in zigzag pathway. This movement of the particles is called Brownian movement. That means random movement actually they used to show. Colloidal particles are big enough to scatter a beam of light passing through it and make its path visible. This phenomenon is called Tyndall effect. With the help of this effect is used to distinguish between true solution and colloidal solution. Now see the diagram. What is Tyndall effect? The Tyndall effect is the scattering of light by particles in a colloid or suspension. Now see this experiment. Light's source is torch. Solution is there, true solution, first one, second one is colloid and the third one is suspension. You can see that it can pass through these colloids but not through suspension and neither through solution. So here are some common examples of Tyndall effect. When a fine beam of light enters the rooms through a small hole, the path of light traversed will be visible due to scattering of light by the particles of dust, smoke in the air. In the winter season, when the air is highly contaminated with dust, mist and other particulate matters, if a beam of torchlight or beam of light from the headlight of train or car travels through the air, its path becomes illuminated and becomes visible. You can do this experiment on your own. So comparative, here the comparative study of three solution, true solution, suspension and colloidal solution. True solution, a mixture of two or more substances in which the solute is completely dissolved in the solvent. The size of particles in a true solution will be less than 1 nanometer in diameter. The size of particles in a colloidal solution will be larger than that of a true solution and smaller than suspension. So, in a true solution, solute can't be seen with a microscope. In a colloid, the dispersed particles can be seen only with a powerful microscope. In a colloid, the size of particles is between 10 to the power minus 7 and 10 to the power minus 9 meter. That means in between 10 to the power minus 7 to 10 to the power minus 9 meter. In a suspension, the size of particles is greater than 10 to the power minus 7 meter. Now, see the chart. Property wise, I am telling. First, particle size. For suspension, it's greater than 100 nanometer. For colloidal solution, it's 1 to 100 nanometer. For solution, it is greater than 100 nanometer. And for suspension, actually, it was less than 100 nanometer. Now, filtration, separation. First, for the first one, possible. For colloidal, not possible. For solution, also not possible. Now, setting of particles settle on their own in case of suspension, settle on centrifugation for colloidal solution, and in case of solution do not settle. Appearance of suspension opaque, in colloidal solution transparent, and solution also transparent. Solution means solution or true solution. Now Tyndall effect. Suspension shows Tyndall effect, colloidal shows Tyndall effect, but solution doesn't show Tyndall effect. Now diffusion of particles. Suspension do not diffuse. Colloidal solution diffuse slowly, but solution diffuse rapidly. Now Brownian movement. Suspension may show, colloidal solution positively shows, and solution, a true solution, may or may not show. Now nature. Suspension is heterogeneous in nature, colloidal solution also heterogeneous in nature, but true solution is homogeneous in nature. Now visibility of particles. Suspension visible with naked eyes, colloidal solution visible under ultra microscope, and true solution is invisible. Now scattering for suspension may scatter light, colloidal solution scatter light, but true solution don't scatter light. Thank you students. For any doubts or queries, please email me at sudeshnaban.sma@outlook.com. After completing this chapter, I am going to give you some questions on water and solution.